In this video, I'm going to do another example of how to write the equation of a line passing through two points. Now, in the previous video, I went over two methods. One is to graph the two points very carefully, draw the line, and then determine the slope by looking at it. And where it passes through the y-axis, you'll be able to determine the y-intercept. In this case, that would be a little difficult. For instance, let's just take a quick look at it. I would have to graph negative 10, 13, and negative 18, negative 7. Okay, so you'd need a pretty big graph, but we could estimate it. Let's say there's negative 10 and that's negative 20. And let's see, got to go all the way up to 13. So let's say that's 10 and that's 20 and that's negative 10, for instance, just sort of getting an idea. So negative 10, 13 is somewhere around here. And negative 18, negative 7 is somewhere around here. You know, I get the idea that it's probably going to be a kind of a steep positive slope, and it looks like the y-intercept is going to be pretty high. So you can do a little rough sketch to just get an idea about what the slope and the y-intercept might be. But it might be kind of hard to get out a piece of graph paper and accurately graph that and tell exactly what the slope is and exactly what the y-intercept is. But it is easy to use the formula for slope to determine the slope exactly, so let's do that first. All right, so we're going to use the formula for slope. We take the first order pair here, and I'm going to put the y over the x in front of the minus sign, 13 over negative 10. And then we'll take the other ordered pair, and after the minus sign, we'll put its y value over its x value. So we have negative 7 over negative 18. All right, so what does this give me if I simplify the top? I have 13 minus negative 7, which is positive 20. And in the denominator, let's see, minus a negative is going to be plus plus. So I have negative 10 plus 18. That will give me 8. So that reduces, dividing the top and bottom by 4 to 5 halves. So I was able to find that the slope of this line is 5 halves, and looking at my picture, that seems reasonable because it looks kind of steep. It's slanting up to the right, so we've got a positive slope. Now we're going to use that slope with one of the ordered pairs, and it doesn't matter which one. I'll choose the first one, negative 10, 13. And now we go back to how we did this when we had to find this, the equation of a line if we had the slope and the y-intercept. And there were a couple methods there as well. You can find b and plug it in the equation or use the point-slope formula. I like the slope-point formula because I plug it in and when I solve for y, I'm done, I have the equation. So let's take the point-slope formula. Y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1, and we are going to plug in 5 halves for the slope. And remember, my x1 is the x coordinate, negative 10, I'm going to plug in for my x1, and 13 is what I'll plug in for my y1. So that's my, remember, my x1 and my y1 coordinate. So this gives me y minus 13 equals 5 halves. X minus a negative 10 is x plus 10. Now once we do this, we can decide, are we going to solve for y and put it in slope-intercept form, or do we want to put it in standard form? I'll do it both ways. First, let's put it in slope-intercept form by solving for y. So I'm going to do two things at once. I'm going to distribute the 5 halves as well as add 13 to both sides. So if I distribute my 5 halves, I have 5 halves x plus, now what's 5 halves times 10? If you can't do that in your head, here it is, 5 halves times 10. You can cancel the 2 into the 10, and I've got 5 times 5. So that's going to be plus 25, and then remember, I need to add my 13 to both sides, so I have plus 13. So in slope-intercept form, I have y equals 5 halves x plus 38. All right, now let's look back at our graph and see if it seems reasonable that the y-intercept was up at 38. So we go back up here. Yeah, remember we said it was going to be pretty steep up there? And so it's going to be kind of a large number. So that looks reasonable. We don't know for sure until we check that both of the points given lie on that line. So that's what we really want to do to check our work. All right, so the original problem was write the equation of the line passing through negative 10, 13, and negative 18, negative 7. And we came up with the equation y equals 5 halves x plus 38. We looked at the graph and that seemed reasonable, but we really want to check. So we're going to check to make sure that each of those points is on that line. So we're going to check negative 10, 13. Let's do that one first. So we're going to plug in negative 10 for x. Oops, I forgot. I'm plugging in also 38 for y. 38 for y and negative 10 for x. Nope, I'm sorry. I'm confusing myself. 13 for y. 13 for y and negative 10 for x. So let's see. Let's make sure that this is true. So I have 5 halves times negative 10. It's going to be negative. The 2 cancels the 10 5 times. So that'll give me negative 25 plus 38. And is that true? Is 13 equal to negative 25 plus 38? Yes. Okay, let's see if I could do the next one without getting confused. The other order pair is negative 18, negative 7. And I'm going to plug it into the equation, y equals 5 halves x plus 38. So the y value is negative 7. And I'm plugging in negative 18 for x. And let's simplify the right-hand side. So the 2 goes into negative 18 9 times, and it's going to be negative. So 9 times 5 is negative 45 plus 38. So is negative 45 plus 38 equal to negative 7? Yes. So we did get the correct equation. Now, I would suggest you take the other order pair, negative 18, negative 7, along with the slope 5 halves, and see if by using the point slope formula you also get y equals 5 halves x plus 38. Or how about we use the order pair negative 18, negative 7 with a slope of 5 halves and use a different method. Remember the method where we write y equals mx plus b and we plug in negative 18 for x, we'll plug in negative 7 for y, and the 5 halves for m, and then we'll be able to solve for b. Remember that method? And you should also get the correct equation. So we have 5 halves times negative 18 plus b. All right, again, 2 goes into negative 18, negative 9 times, so that's negative 45. Plus b, and if we just add 45 to both sides, we get that b is 38. So you know what? We just keep coming up with the same equation, y equals 5 halves x plus 38. And we already checked that, right? This would just be another way of using a different ordered pair and a different method. As long as you use one of these two ordered pairs with one of the methods, given the slope and a point, you should be able to get the correct equation.